So Netflix just recently announced that they're going to be doing a prequel series to one of the most classic Jim Henson movies of all time, The Dark Crystal. And this new TV series will be called Dark Crystal, Age of Resistance. Now, if you don't know what the Dark Crystal movie was, Jim Henson actually thought this was one of his best, most creative movies ever. It's kind of a dark sci-fi movie, but it still has the Jim Henson feel to it. So there's a little bit of whimsy to it, but it is a dark setting. And just to kind of break down a little bit about what that 1982 project was, because I honestly, I'd heard of it. I'd seen things when I saw screenshots of it, but I've never seen that movie myself. It was out before I was born, so.
I haven't seen it either. This is not one of the ones I think of with Jim Henson either. And I've seen ones from before I was born.
It looks really, really cool. And it's something that I am going to go back and watch before this new series comes out. So I'm excited to discover something new. But a pretty basic, very, very basic synopsis of The Dark Crystal is you have this giant crystal that's in this world of like magic and mystery. And I think there's like elves and different races already running around. And at one day, this crystal splits and two races come out of it. One is an evil race and one is a good race. The evil race is like these vulture looking things. And then the good race is like a bunch of wizards or something. And an elf that lives in this realm who was taken in by the good wizards goes on a journey to heal the crystal and stop the evil, I think they're called skeezes or something like that, from taking over forever. And he has to heal the crystal in a certain amount of time or else, boom, that's it. Skeezes, they take over, they win. So that's the basic as basic can come synopsis to the story. But a couple things you can pull out of that is, number one, Jim Henson probably, and I again, without seeing the movie, I can almost guarantee he went out of his way to create a very rich and deep world in this mythos. So that's one thing to look forward to. Number two is greatest puppeteer of all time. I mean, right? Is it even close? Like, can you think of anybody else who ever did anything close to what Jim Henson has done?
I can't think of very many other people that even attempted it after he came along. Like, even Yoda was done by Jim Henson. Like,
yeah, dude. I mean, like, any iconic, like, puppet-like
Sesame
thing
Street,
you can think of.
Jim Henson.
Jim Henson. Muppets. Jim Henson. I mean, just, and just, it goes, the list goes on and on and on. Like, I could pull up his IMDb, and we'd be here for another hour while I read off all the iconic things he has done. So, I do, and they are, Netflix is working with the Jim Henson production company, which still does great work with puppetry and animatronics and all that stuff. So, I'm hoping that. And the other thing I liked about Jim Henson, now this is going to sound very vain, but as a kid watching Sesame Street and stuff, his son Brian Henson took over after him. And I just always liked it that he had the same name as me and he made all these really cool things. So,
all right. That's
Brendan's like, move on, okay. Brian, move on. So I am excited to see this prequel series because it seems like there's such a rich history to dive into here. Because I'm not 100% sure where the movie takes off, but I don't believe it takes it starts off where the crystal splits. So it sounds like we're going to have plenty of that. And it being titled Age of Resistance sounds like we are going to get some darker tones, some maybe some battle scenes, but hopefully it won't go too far in the realm of darkness. It keeps that levity that Jim Henson was known for. Even if you watched Labyrinth, I mean, that the David Bowie musical, that was really dark at times, but it still, you know, never took you to the part. Like if you were a little kid and watching it, yeah, you felt a little scared at points, but it wasn't something that, you know, it wasn't like watching Freddy Krueger when you were a kid. You know, you weren't going to, you know, pee your pants because you're so scared. You'd be a little bit scared, but you would still have a good time with it. So I hope they can really capture that essence and bring that forward, because that would be a show that I would love to watch. And let's be honest, this is Netflix. I mean, this is, we can almost guarantee that it's going to be good. I'm trying to think right now, racking my brain, for something bad that they've done, and maybe
their children's shows are pretty bad, good. Brian. Huh? And this actually we might have trouble here, because their children's shows have frequently been fairly
but
bad.
But this isn't quite a children's show. This is kind of a bordering.
That's what I'm saying. Like. And the DreamWorks stuff that they've done has been fine. So maybe we can see.
Hey, I'm hoping for the best.
So,
but it is up. Let us know what you think. Are you excited to see a Dark Crystal Age of Resistance TV show on Netflix? Or you think it's better left in the 80s? I don't know. Hit us up. Let us know. Comments down below. Of course, @WordsForMyFace on Twitter, Google+, and Facebook. Always good ways of getting a hold of us.